Dear students, so this is lecture number 3 on the topic steam turbine. So in this topic, in this lecture, we are going to discuss about compounding of steam turbines. Compounding of steam turbine is the strategy in which energy from the steam is extracted in number of stages rather than a single stage in a turbine. So in the previous lecture, we discussed the single stage impulse turbine. What is the limitation or the disadvantage of the single stage impulse turbine is the exit velocity from the turbine. So the exit velocity is very high for a single stage impulse turbine. Now we have to utilize the velocity of the steam effectively in a steam turbine. For that, we are going for multiple stages. So using the steam energy, the enthalpy of the steam in more than one stage, it is called as compounding of steam turbine. So there will be number of stages. So in a practical case, in a practical steam turbine, the number of stages will be around 30 to 40 depending on the power generation. So the there are three different types of compounding: velocity compounded steam turbine, pressure compounded steam turbine, velocity and pressure compounded steam turbine, that is combined velocity and pressure compounded steam turbine. So we'll discuss the velocity compounded steam turbine separately, pressure compounded steam turbine separately, and velocity and pressure compounded turbine combined of the two effects. First, we take the velocity compounded steam turbine. So here, the velocity is used in multiple stages. So look at the diagram. We have a nozzle at the entrance of the turbine. Next to that, we have a moving blade. Then we have the fixed blade and moving blade. So this is a two-stage velocity compounded steam turbine. First stage consists of a nozzle and a moving blade. Second stage consists of a fixed blade and the moving blade. And similarly, if you can add number of stages. So number of stages, suppose if you have 30 stages, you will have 30 such fixed blade and moving blade alternatively. So you have fixed blade, moving blade alternatively for number of stages. But in the velocity compounded steam turbine, we have only one set of nozzles at the entrance of the turbine. So the nozzle, the pressure, the steam enters with the boiler pressure. The pressure drop, the complete pressure drop is taking place. So from the boiler pressure to the condenser pressure, all the pressure drop is taking place in the nozzle. So the pressure drop is converted into velocity. So in the nozzle, what is the main function of the function of the nozzle is converting the enthalpy or pressure of the energy of the steam into kinetic energy, pressure energy of the steam into kinetic energy. So velocity is increased. So for the corresponding to this pressure drop, there is increase in the velocity. Now the velocity is used in the number of stages. So first moving blade, there is certain percentage of decrease in velocity. So the decrease in velocity in the moving blade, it is converted into work done, and then the velocity remains constant in the fixed blade. So you have a fixed blade, it is attached to the casing of the machine. The purpose of the fixed blade is to deflect the steam to the next moving blade without loss of velocity or pressure. Practically, without loss of, there is no change in the velocity across the fixed blade, there is no change in the pressure across the fixed blade. So without loss of any of the energies, it is just deflecting the steam to the next moving blade. And in the next moving blade, the steam energy, velocity of the steam is utilized once again, and there is decrease in velocity, and it is leaving the outer velocity, the steam is leaving with the velocity. Now the power produced by two moving blades. So the moving blade one, moving blade two, both are attached to the common shaft. So the power is produced by the velocity compounded steam turbine. The velocity compounded steam turbine first invented, designed by Curtis. So that is what is called as Curtis steam turbine. Velocity compounded steam turbine, it is named after the inventor cut a steam turbine. What are the disadvantages here? So if you look at the nozzle, we have only one set of nozzle. So the all the pressure drop is taking place only one nozzle. So the nozzle should be bigger. At the same time, it should be stronger to handle the complete pressure drop. Number two, as you have only one nozzle, the velocity is used in the number of stages. The outlet velocity will have some significant value. So the outlet velocity in the velocity common turbine, it is also higher. So the velocity common turbine, it is actually, we have only one nozzle, and the nozzle should be stronger and nozzle should be bigger, and the outlet velocity, there is loss of velocity at the outlet of the turbine also. Then the order. So you have the similar type of velocity triangle. Inlet velocity for stage 1, new inlet 1, moving blade 2, and fixed blade. So the velocity triangle, inlet velocity triangle, outlet velocity triangle, and with this velocity is entering the second stage. So second moving blade, inlet velocity triangle, and outlet velocity triangle. Work done for the first stage, VB into VW1 plus VW2. Work done for the stage 2, VB into VW1 dash plus VW2 dash. So we have dash, the prime, the dash for this notation. And finally, work done equal to W1 plus W2, and power produced equal to M into total work done. That is what the power produced by the impulse turbine. So you have to calculate, analytically, you have to calculate all the values. The next one is pressure compounded steam turbine. Now look at the pressure compounded steam turbine. Now this is the stage 1. We have a set of nozzle and a moving blade. And the stage 2, again set of nozzles and moving blade. So like that, you may have any number of stages. So the pressure compounded steam turbine, it is combination of or number of single stages arranged in series. So the pressure compounded steam turbine, wherein you have the number of single stage steam turbine arranged in series. So this is a single stage turbine. You have a nozzle and a moving blade. This is another single stage turbine. You have a nozzle and a moving blade. Now, what is the function? So the pressure drop. So you have two stages of the turbine here. So the pressure, boiler pressure, the steam enters with the boiler pressure. There is partial pressure drop. So for the pressure drop, there is increase in the velocity. Then the velocity is used in the moving blade and the pressure remains constant. So in the moving blade, pressure remains constant. For an impulse turbine, the pressure remains constant in the across the moving blade. Then next level, next nozzle, once again there is a drop in the pressure and there is increase in the velocity. For the drop in pressure, there is increase in velocity, and this velocity is used in the next set of moving blade. Now the pressure drop is distributed to different nozzles. So in the pressure compounded turbine, pressure drop is distributed to the pressure, different types of nozzle, different numbers of nozzle. So you require a moderate or smaller size of nozzle comparing with the velocity compounded turbine. But still, the velocity is considerable. Outlet, the velocity is considerable. So we have to have, the velocity at the outlet will be higher. Still, it is higher. So the pressure compounded impulse turbine. And the Ratiu is the scientist. Ratiu is the scientist who invented, designed and fabricated the pressure compounded turbine. So the pressure compounded turbine is named after his name, after Ratiu. So it is called as Ratiu turbine. And look at this pressure and velocity compounded turbine. Now the combination. So this is the first stage, second stage. You may take this is the third stage and fourth stage. The first two stages, you combine, you take the first stage and the second stage, it is velocity compounded. The second, third stage and the fourth stage, once again, it is velocity compounded. If you take the entire, all the four stages, then it is called as pressure compounded, pressure and velocity compounded combined. So you have the first nozzle, moving blade, fixed blade, moving blade. Again, a nozzle, fixed blade, moving blade, and then moving blade. Now, the pressure, the boiler pressure enters with the steam, enters with the boiler pressure, there is partial pressure drop. So, for this pressure drop, there is increase in the velocity. So, the increase in velocity is utilized in two sets of moving blades. So moving blade one, there is pressure velocity drop and the velocity remains constant in the fixed blade. And then once again, there is drop in the velocity. So the power is produced. Then the velocity remains constant between the stages. Then again, there is another set of nozzle. There is pressure drop. Corresponding to this pressure drop, there is increase in velocity. And this velocity is used in the, again, two sets of moving blade. So this is what velocity and pressure compounded steam turbine. This is what practically used. We are not using a exclusive velocity compounded turbine or exclusive pressure compounded turbine. In a practical engine, practical steam turbine power plant, we design the steam turbine with the combined velocity and pressure compounded turbine. Now we'll have a quiz. Which of the following is a pressure compounded turbine? If your answer is Ratayu turbine, you are correct. Which of the following is a velocity compounded turbine? Parsons turbine, Curtis turbine, Ratayu turbine, all the three. So the answer is Curtis turbine. So thank you.